Hi everyone, I'm Carmel, director and floral designer here at Popular Florals. Everyone's always asking us for more behind the scenes stuff, and most recently a warehouse tour, but we've just been in the process of moving. Say hi to Ian in the background there, everyone, as well, by the way. We've been in the process of moving since November into our new unit, so we've still just been getting that settled. We're getting there now. This is like the office space. But my friend over at Ollie Blogs, he's the farmer that was behind the sunflower farm last year, Sunflower Maze. He's been running a YouTube channel, and I had an inspirational chat with him yesterday, and he was saying how successful his has been and how people have really enjoyed seeing behind the scenes, and how it's not as daunting as you think, and it's just kind of recording a bit of the day-to-day stuff that goes on here anyway. I find that a bit strange because I think we just do it daily, and I didn't think anyone would really be interested. But to be fair, you do ask a lot on our stories and things for some more behind the scenes, so I just thought we'd try and make a little bit of a conscious effort and do some more recording and show you some of the less glamorous stuff and some of the work that goes into putting our designs together. You know, we'll obviously share pictures of completed designs, and we'll share, you know, tiny bits of little snippets of things. But for example, Stacey Solomon's design for the In the Style shoot, that was a lot of weeks in the making, a lot of hours on the a lot of hours here prepping. There was a lot of hours sourcing stock from all over Europe and designing, and then obviously the actual hours on site installing. So there's actually quite a lot that goes into the process that we've never actually really shown, for no reason really, other than not having the time and not realizing that it would be something that people would like to see. So we just thought we'd give it a go. We might bore you to death, who knows. So there's myself as director and lead floral designer. Ian is my partner. He runs all of the websites, so any of the website stuff that you guys see, and the stock, Ian's kind of over all of that side to it, and all of the rest of the businessy stuff. And then we've got Helen and Dan at the minute, and I can take you down and say hi to them shortly. But yeah, if people have got any ideas about what kinds of content and things that they would like to see, we're very open to suggestions because we're new to this. And I guess we don't see it as intriguing because it's just part of our everyday lives. But if there's something specific that you think you'd find interesting, then drop us a message and let us know. And don't forget to subscribe at the bottom of this video so that you can see what more we've got to share. We've got some exciting projects coming up in the next couple of weeks, a few restaurants that have been in the works for a long time, so we're gonna be conscious to share some more of them in the lead up to it. Yeah, so come and see. So I think lots of you will know Daniel already.
Go away.
I had loads to do today, so I thought I'd start YouTube instead.
Stop it.
Gotta say hello.
Hi everyone.
And this is Helen, and she's actually gonna boot me if I put her on camera. We're gonna start with a little warehouse tour. The guys have literally done so much to it over the past few months. There's still quite a bit we've got to do. I think we've still got bits of painting and things, but obviously there was the pandemic, we closed for a while, and we moved in November, which is always our busiest time of year. So, front door, boring, obviously, from there. So this bit is a bit of like a Well, it's the entrance, but it was going to be a bit of a, we don't have people on site, so we don't need a reception. We're going to turn this bit into our bit photography kind of area because it has the best lighting by a mile. There's a neon sign coming tomorrow that says like good vibes only. That's going to go in there in the pink. And then we use the paper roll backdrops at the minute because we don't have to do that much like photography really on in here, but we're gonna get the proper wall mounted one, so that'll be our proper little photography little bit. It's still like stuff that hasn't been homed yet. Just our little kitchen. It's obviously a family business. Again, this is the kitchen's fitted now. We're still waiting for the tap and stuff to get plumbed in. Just like small little fiddly bits that at the minute are taking so long. This is all our recycling. We go through so much cardboard, you can imagine. But we recycle all the Liverpool councils, so they come and collect once a month. Toilet block, this bit, shutter door, so we keep our trolleys here with all of the stuff that we need to restock frequently to load the van. So this is usually like tools, tapes, toolboxes. The van's actually packed at the minute, so there's not as much here, but trolley glue, all of the everyday essentials for while we're out installing, they kind of go here. This is going to be the orders out area, so once orders are picked and packed, they will go here waiting for our daily DPD collection. But this is new stuff that's just arrived. These will be actually on the website later today, I would imagine. There's just so much. It's been such a big chore to organise. So we split the warehouse into two. So we've got, this is all, these bays are all racking. Look at them laughing at me. They hate me. so these three bays are racking, for all the four racking. This is all website stuff. So this is where we store all of that. These are just being sorted. I think these were leftovers from an installation, so these will get counted and then put back into my inventory, or sometimes we list bits on the website, depending on how popular they've been. We're waiting on some new packing stations to be made for us. And then the back half, the workshop. So this is huge, this space. We've got our, this is my kind of leftover bits and pieces and my flowers. It's where we make our hanger baskets or we do any prep for installs. We've got the workbenches, and then we've got quite a lot of floor space because we use quite a lot on the floor. We'll do arches and things. And we're just trying to, oh, I don't know, we're trying to find a place for things, try to keep it separate, like wood, that kind of stuff. And then some of our metal work, it just depends. Obviously a lot of our designs are on freestanding frames. These boxes have been, we have all boxes for shipping our products and stuff, but we keep some spare aside, some that have brought our deliveries in, because it's always handy to have some spare sizes for taking stock to jobs and things. This would be the returns bit once it's sorted. At the minute these are just things that haven't been unpacked. And then obviously I felt like a pink staircase was more important than all the practical stuff I should have done. It's not actually finished yet. Got our logo there. And this is the offices. So I've got my desk and Ian's desk and a bit of a seating area for anyone. That's for the guys when they've got their mini bits and pieces to do. And then we've got the area for the girls because obviously they're always with us.
busy.
Anyway.
Because I've run out of things to say.
End the video then.
But yeah, bear with us. I'll get used to it. I'll get used to this weird angle. I feel like my head's like that. And send over any ideas and bits and pieces of the specific things that you want to see behind the scenes. Let us know.